Acal is a distributor, designer and manufacturer of niche customised electronics to industrial customers. For example, the company sources and sells the temperature sensor for the popular Nespresso coffee machine, and it is the only stockist of this part. Well, today the company's released its trading update for the first half, with sales rising by 30%, like-for-like sales rising by 2% with gross margin higher and operating margins climbing above 5%. Well, Nick Jefferies is the chief executive. He joins us now. Now, Nick, good numbers, yet there's a sense of caution in terms of your outlook. And I'm thinking, you know, almost 80% of your revenues are from outside the UK, and the IMF saying recently global economic growth is likely to be weaker than earlier expected. So what about demand from your customer base?
Hello, Sarah. Yeah, we think that definitely there has been some slowing, particularly in North America and Asia, which are small but important markets for us. The area that encourages us most is that after several years of particular softness, continental Europe continues to show better and growing strength. We track money supply in particular, and over the last few months that has remained quite strong and is usually a good indicator of industrial output. So we think that continental Europe is doing relatively well, but we just have a word of caution that with the US having slowed and China potentially slowing, that may have a dragging effect on some of our European customers. Although we haven't really seen that yet, we wouldn't be surprised if we saw a bit of that in the second half.
Now, you talk about continental Europe there, because apparently Spain's GDP growth is the surprise. Have you got a good presence there?
We have a small presence in Spain. Most of our continental European business is in the northern parts of Europe, so Germany, Nordic, Benelux, but also a significant presence in France.
Okay, you mentioned Germany there. Any exposure to the car industry, or is the VW emissions scandal just hitting sentiment overall?
We supply into the automotive channel to a small extent. We have between 6% and 8% of our group sales end up somewhere into the automotive channel. But very importantly, none of it goes into the big tier one suppliers such as VW or BMW or Audi. We don't engage with those customers. That's not our target customer base. Where we tend to be most successful in the automotive area is in supplying custom components and equipment into manufacturers of manufacturing equipment and test equipment that goes into manufacture and test some of the equipment in the automotive market. So we supply the tier two, tier three channels into the automotive market, not the prime tier ones.
But there is the argument that the tier two and tier three are going to be affected by the VW scandal, that we're all going to suffer. So therefore, you know, further down the line, 3 or 4 months, you might experience that knock-on effect.
Well, I'd never say never, but I think that they are likely, more of that spend is CapEx related, and that has seen an uptick in Germany over the last year. I think if there were to be a slowdown in CapEx, then we would probably, we would see it later on in the year, and it would, if it were to come through, it would probably be to a smaller degree than, i.e. less oscillation than perhaps any oscillation in people buying cars and VWs and the like.
Okay. Now, within the first half, which order are you most proud to have won?
Well, we have many large customers that we are proud to deal with, big international names. It would be probably tactless of me to mention any one particular customer by name, but what we are encouraged by is increasing capital expenditure among the Tier 1 industrial companies. So companies that build infrastructure tend to be doing quite a bit better, both in Europe and internationally at the moment. And we think that's probably a reflection of, you know, several government initiatives to increase infrastructure spending and the like. But we definitely see some benefit from that.
Okay, so what about the opportunities to cross-sell your design and manufacturing expertise to the 20,000 or so clients on your custom distribution database?
Yeah, cross-selling is an important initiative for us. What it aims to do is to sell more product into existing customers of ours. So where we might sell, for example, a magnetic product, we also want to be able to sell a customer a power product or possibly even a communications product or something like that into the same or an adjoining application. We've made quite a lot of progress on that over the last 18 months, and we'll be reporting the figures in our interim results in November. But we've on this trading update, all we're really declaring is that we continue to grow that business quite well, and we're very pleased with that.
Okay, ahead of that statement in November, when I hope I'll be speaking to you, what about the future order pipeline? How would you describe it compared to previous years?
We have quite a steady order flow. It oscillates depending upon sort of stock market sentiment. If the stock market booms, then orders tend to pick up a bit, and then if it eases off, then orders sort of slow a bit. So you get a bit more oscillation in orders than you do actually in sales. What we were particularly encouraged by was the strength of September, actually. We saw a slowing in August, which you might say is partly related to all of the stock market jitters that were around that time. But as September progressed, we saw quite a strength in sales demand, a growing strength in sales demand, and that gave us a very good finish to the half year.
Okay, now broker Peel Hunt has reduced its organic growth estimate for the company. Will the balance be redressed with more acquisitions?
There are two parts to our business. The organic growth is always important, but obviously it's modulated by economic sentiment, and that's what that's what we're seeing in our outlook for the second half. We think that whilst organic growth will continue, it'll be a shade lower, reflecting those conditions. Where we really are able to accelerate the value creation that we're providing to shareholders is through buying well-priced businesses that we can integrate quite quickly and then start cross-selling. And we have a pipeline. We always have a pipeline, and we continue to have a good pipeline of opportunities that we expect to sort of progress over the next few months.
Okay, finally and briefly, how would you describe your dividend policy?
Progressive. So where we create extra value, then we intend always to pass some of that on to the shareholders.
Nick Jefferies, Chief Executive of Acal, thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Thank you.